Mr. President, South Carolina calls the question.
What's that, Mr. Rutledge?
I said, Mr. President, South Carolina desires to end the debate and calls the question of independence.
Delaware, second.
Please! The question has been called and seconded.
The secretary will record the vote.
Franklin, do something. Think.
I'm thinking, but nothing's coming.
All those in favor of the resolution on independence as proposed by the colony of Virginia signify by saying...
Excuse me, is this the Continental Congress? Oh, yes, I can see that it must be.
It's all right, we found it.
We've been looking for you everywhere, you see. Someone told us that you might be at Carpenter's Hall, and someone else suggested Library Hall, and... So finally, we ask a constable.
Excuse me, sir, but if you don't mind, the Congress is about to decide the question of American independence.
Oh, how splendid. That means we're not too late. These gentlemen are Mr. Francis Hopkinson, Mr. Richard Stockton, and I am the Reverend John Witherspoon. We're the new delegates from New Jersey. Dr. Franklin, I regret that I must be the bearer of unhappy tidings, sir, but your son, the royal governor of New Jersey, has been taken prisoner and has been moved under guard to the colony of Connecticut for safekeeping.
Is he unharmed, sir?
When last I heard, he was, yes, sir.
Well, then why the long face? I hear Connecticut's an excellent location. Tell me, why did they arrest the little bastard?
New Jersey legislature has recalled the old delegation to this Congress and has sent a new one.
Quickly, man, where do you stand on independence?
Well, haven't I made that clear?
No.
Well, I suppose I hadn't, but that's the reason for the change. See, we've been instructed to vote for independence.
President, Massachusetts is now ready for the vote on independence and reminds the chair of its privilege to decide all votes that are deadlocked.
I won't forget, Mr. Adams. The chair takes this opportunity to welcome the New Jersey delegation and appoints the Reverend Witherspoon congressional chaplain, if he will accept the post.
With much pleasure, sir.
Very well. Mr. Thompson, you may now proceed with the vote on independence.
All in favor of the resolution on independence, as proposed by the colony of Virginia, signify by saying...
Mr. President, Pennsylvania moves that... Any vote in favor of independence must be unanimous.
What?
I second the motion.
Judge Wilson!
Oh, my God.
Delaware seconds, Mr. President.
No vote has ever had to be unanimous, Dickinson, and you know it.
Yes, but this one must be.
On what grounds?
That no colony be torn from its mother country without its own consent.
Hear, hear.
It will never be unanimous, damn it.
If you say so, Mr. Adams.
It has been moved and seconded that the vote on independence must be unanimous in order to carry. All those in favor signify by saying yay.
Yay. Yay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And 6 colonies say yay. Against?
Nay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 colonies say nay.
Mr. Secretary, New York abstains, courteously.
Mr. Morris.
Why does New York constantly abstain? Why does New York simply stay in New York?
Very well, the vote is tied. The principles of independence have no greater advocate in Congress than its president. That is why I must join those who vote for unanimity.
Good God, John, what are you doing? You've sunk us!
Now, hear me out. Don't you see that any colony who opposes independence will be forced to fight on the side of England?
What the hell? That we'll be setting brother against brother. That our new nation will carry as its emblem the mark of Cain.
No, I can see no other way.
Either we all walk together, or together we must stay where we are.
A man's from Massachusetts.
Very well. Proceed, Mr. Thompson.